Hey everyone, it's Wireless Productions. We're going to do an unboxing of our ATL fuel cell that we just got recently. We have one of these fuel cells in the CUDA, and we love it so much we got a second one for the 73 Challenger build that we're going to be doing. First of all, shout out to Shatar04, Shatar04 for being so generous and hooking us up. It was a big part of his generosity that provided us a fuel cell. So thanks again, Shatar04. You're awesome, man. Appreciate it. So we'll cut it open. As you can see, the box is still sealed from ATL. It's pretty big. It's like 40 pounds. But here it goes. Let's see what's inside. ATL is awesome because they're using all the major motorsport series, F1, NASCAR, TA2 uses a different brand, but I think that's because of cost reasons, but ATL makes good stuff. Like I said, this is the second one we have. We have a lot of experience with their products, so that's why we're going to get another one for the Challenger. So there's some foam packaging. So I guess they use that standing foam to package it. Pain in the ass to get it out, but it's worth it if your parts come in damaged. First of all, I think this is the steel. This is the steel cover plate, but there's the fuel cell itself. Check it out. We opted for the aluminum box, and the center fuel plate. So this is a fuel sender. This is the fill cap. That's a vent. That's a return. And this is for the water, the fuel pump. So that's that. They changed out the bolts This used to be bolts on the CUDA, but now that it looks like Allen head screws. So, but yeah, made in USA ATL Inc. This is the MAX Sports Cell. Yeah, I'm pretty sure this is a steel cover plate. They should have sent me an aluminum one, which is the red version, but I guess that's fine. We'll call them Monday about that. There's a part number, SP122C-MAX. When you order the MAX option, it changes everything to the aluminum lightweight version. This is a SP122C, which is 22 gallons nominal, and it really holds about 17 to 18 gallons when all said and done. There's all this foam in there, but we'll see if we can take out the foam and show you guys what's inside. So here's the fuel cell unwrapped out of the plastic. They definitely sent me the wrong fill plate. This is a TF-195, where it should have been a TF-600, where this blue plate is a steel plate, and the TF-600 is an aluminum plate. It's a little bit lighter. I mean, it shouldn't be a big deal, but I actually like blue better than red. The aluminum fill plate is red, but I paid for what I paid for, so I'm going to call ATL Monday and figure out what happened. They probably ran out of the aluminum fill plates, but I'm gonna ask them if I can get it switched out. They also sent me this fuel sender or send light switch light or something, warning light, and then they sent this KS 208 fuel level kit. I actually don't need this. This is a nice fuel level, but I don't need it because we're going to use an AIM sports data logger electronic dash, where it already has a fuel sending fuel gauge built into the TFT dash display. So we're not going to use this. So I'm going to see if I can return and get some money back. I know these are expensive from ATL, but like I said, I'm not going to use it, and I didn't order it, so I don't know why they sent it to me. But I'll call them and get to the bottom of it on Monday. But what we'll do now is we'll disassemble these hex nuts or Allen head nuts. They should have been hex nuts. That's what it was in the CUDA. It is in the CUDA, but we'll disassemble these and show you what's inside. We need to cannibalize the foam from this fuel cell anyways, because the fuel cell that we bought for the CUDA is getting to 5 years old. I think we bought that back in 2014, and the foam does degrade. So what we're going to do is take the foam out of this fuel cell and then install it into the CUDA, and then when it times come time to install this into the 73 Challenger, we're just going to buy brand new foam and just stuff it in here, so it'll be fresh foam, and it'll be good to go. It's not going to be a while till we install the cell. We have to build a fuel cell cage underneath the car, underneath the Challenger, so it's not going to be a while until that happens. But let me pause the video and then disassemble it, and I'll show you guys from there. So here's the fuel cell bolts all disassembled. These are Allen head bolts. They're 5/32. You have to use the Allen key to take them off. They were bolts in the CUDA, so I'm not sure why they changed them to these Allen head screws. I like the bolts better, to be honest with you. But here's the fill plate. I took them all off, and so this is what's inside. There's a fuel level sender. It's made in USA as well. There's the return. There's a flapper valve. This is the fuel pump out. This is a wiring, this is a rollover vent. So what I'm after is the yellow foam here that's inside the fuel cell. Place that down very carefully, not to mar the aluminum. So the black box is here. This is a nice option with the sports cells, is that it comes with a black box. Let me take the foam out and see if we can take it out here. Yeah. So here's the black box coming out. Yeah, it's wedged in there pretty tight by the foam. You just have to be careful to take everything out so you don't fuck anything up. So there's a black box. This comes with a Walbro pump. It's ready for 600 horsepower. But it comes with the trap doors, which is nice. Like I said, we run the exact same setup on the CUDA, and we've never, ever, ever, ever had any fuel starvation issues or anything like that. And the problem is the fuel running out, because we ran the tank dry or something. But other than that, we never ever had an issue with these fuel cells from ATL, so that's why we bought a second one. Like I said, this is what I'm after, is the foam from this fuel cell. Like I said, I'm gonna replace the CUDA's 5-year-old foam with this stuff. So I'm gonna pull it out. Stuff this into the CUDA's fuel cell after we drain it. Probably after the track day we go to next. The foam here is pretty durable, but it does degrade, especially due to alcohol in today's fuels. The E10. E15 blends there at pump gas, so ATL recommends to replace this at least every 3 years. But that's what we got to sell, and then we're gonna replace it as soon as we plan this year. Like I said, it's wedged in there, but it's just foam. You just gotta be careful not to behind. See, it's cut out to accept the black box that goes there, and this goes to the rear of the fuel cell. Don't let any other builder tell you otherwise. But I'm gonna take out the rest of the foam. You guys don't need to see that, but this is pretty much what's inside an ATL fuel cell. Like I said, we love them, and I'm a big fan of their products. But that's it for now. This is Rylus Productions. See you guys later.